Get ready to have your developers bow down to you. There's a deal that's going on right now that's called Bird Eats Bug. And what it actually does, it lets you report bugs in a real professional way. So let's just take, for example, that you want to reproduce a bug. Well, you're recording the screen, but you're not just only going to pass on the video. While you're recording the screen, Bird Eats Bugs is actually capturing information on the back end. So it's actually capturing errors, clicks, movements, and time frame of what's actually going on. So the developer is going to get a video plus the error log on the right. So that's really useful information for them to analyze where the error is actually happening. There's also the option to take a screenshot or bug watch a specific site. So it's a pretty interesting deal that I find that will save a lot of time for your developers, or if you're just going to report a bug to someone that you are finding a bug on a site. So it's pretty useful. Let's go check out this deal and how it actually works. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. Okay, before we jump into the deal, first let me show you a quick example of what it does, because I know you're eager to find out what it actually does. So I have the Chrome extension installed and I have this options available. I can record the tab that I'm actually on right now. I can record the screen and select the screen, the tab, or the browser. I can take a screenshot. I can enable microphone, webcam, and bug watch. So let me record the screen really quickly here. And I'll just say I'll record this Chrome screen. Okay. So now it's recording and it's actually recording the video plus the backend log of what's going on. So let's just start off with this one. And I'm going to contact us. I'm going to say testing, send. Here we go. Okay, that didn't send. All right, so that is a bug. Let's stop our recording, okay? And then we're gonna get this, right? So we have the video on the left and we have the console steps on the right. So the developer is going to view the video plus what's going on. So that means I clicked on it and this is the things that I clicked on. This is the error, it's a 404 error. So it's saying that this file is wrong, okay? Something's wrong with it, okay? And I clicked on it twice, and that's why we got 2x404. Plus, we also get network information. So the FAV icon is a 200 status, and you're gonna get the status for all the information on that site. So if I click on it, I get more information, like the header, the response header, and the request header. We can see the JS, XR, other. Now, some of these might sound weird to even me, but developers will know what it's for, and the system info. So in this case, they know that I'm on a Mac OS, what's my version, the Chrome version that I'm using, the engine, the screen, the window, the type, vendor, and all that information is useful for them. And if they want to replay it, well, they're actually viewing the video, and let me go into the console, and the steps by time frame. See how it's moving and what it's doing? That information is key for developers. Now, we have several options for this. Right now, this information is cached on my desktop. That means that no one has any information of this, not even Bird Eats Bug. This will only happen if I upload the video. So I have the option to upload it because I want to share this with the developer, okay? Now, you have the option to share this with developers in your team, which you can assign them here and by team members, or you can say it's public. Now you can set it to private if you like, because you only wanna keep it private for your team members, or you can keep it for anyone. In my use case, I'm going to use this to report bugs when I'm on a SaaS, testing LTDs and all of that. So I'll keep it public and I set it as default. So now that it's public, I'm going to copy it and I'll go into incognito mode. Okay, let's go into the link. I've sent this link to the developer and this is what the developer is going to look at. So the developer instantly is going to view, it's okay, there's a video on this. There's a time log over here. Okay, so he clicked on that. And okay, this is what's going on. Here's the issue, 404 error on this. Okay, so the developer is gonna dig into that specific file to find out what's going on. And it's gonna be able to filter in the clicks, errors, networks, and see what he actually wants to view, the network and the system info. So he's gonna get access to this. There's no need for logging in, creating accounts, nothing, all right? So you can send this to anyone that you want to report that bug. Plus, this is also saved on your workspace. So these are tests that I've been playing with, and there's a workspace for this, and we can actually set a label to it. Now, in a nutshell, that's it. We're gonna go into more in depth with this, but first, let me show you the deal that's going on right now. So right now the deal starts off at $49 for the lifetime deal, and that's what I got. That's enough for me. And let me show you what that actually gets you. So you get all of this: unlimited storage, sharing via public private links, unlimited bug reports, encryption, and these are the license tier, okay? So I got one for $49, which is 5 members and 3 months data retention. I don't need more than 5 members or 3 months data retention. Now, my use case is not for using it for my own development or SaaS. I'm going to use it to report bugs when I'm testing out these deals and all of that, and it's gonna help out others. But if you're gonna use this for in-house, and if you need more members, I recommend you jump into license tier 2 or 3 for this. But at the end of the day, any of these licenses will get all the features for it. So if you're good with license tier 1, then you're good to go, okay? So like I said, this is more than just a screen recorder. Now, let me go jump into one of my sites. So I'm logged into this WordPress site that I'm on, and I'm gonna start this recorder, okay? I can also start the bug watch for this specific site. So if anything's going on, even if I'm not recording the tab, I'm gonna get little numbers saying, you know what, we found 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 100 bugs, whatever. And it's gonna show me on the Chrome extension little icon. So in this case, I'm going to, again, record the screen. I'm gonna select Chrome, and it started. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna mess around quickly through this site, and I'm gonna do some updates. This is just a test site that I'm playing with for right now, and I'll just update this plugin. The idea is to show you a lot of things that are going on and how it's going to give that error report, okay? So right now it's recording, it's done. I'll jump into this hotels. There we go. And let's go ahead and stop it. Okay, so this is what I've got right here. And you can see there's one error that popped up, which is this one right here. I can see the logs. Remove networks, show networks, the steps if I want to show them. I can play with the video, see what's going on. I can set the title and description for this. I can view the network, see how I'm getting all these 200 status, and I got one right here. So something's going on with this specific file. So I'm able to view this, or the developer is going to be able to view what's going on while I'm actually reproducing the error that I found, the bug, all right? And again, we see the system info. I can upload this if I want, but in this case, I'm just testing it. So no need to upload. Now, another feature that you're going to find is that, like I said before, we can enable the bug watch on specific sites. So in this case, I have it enabled. And what I did is that I enabled some blockers and some of that. So it's gonna report several bugs on this site. So let's just jump into another place of this site. So no bugs found there. Let's go jump into the next one. No, nothing so far. Let's go into buy now. Nothing. Okay, so nothing's changed. Oh, okay, there we go. So now I detected 5 errors. See how that happened without actually recording the screen, taking screenshots or anything like that? I'm already getting all these errors right here. So I can view the errors really quickly right here, the most recent ones, or I can view the session for this one. Now, bug watch can be turned on or off on the sites that you want to have it on or off, okay? So you can see the error log right here of what's going on. Right now, it didn't record the screen because that's not what it's actually doing. It's just recording errors that it might find on that specific site because I have it turned on. So it's really useful if you're constantly working on a site and you have that on, because you're gonna be able to view it while you're actually working on it, moving around with it, or just testing it, okay? So that's a pretty cool feature that you have on that. Again, I'm gonna leave it because I don't want to record it or anything like that. And that's a playground. Again, let's go ahead and go into screenshot now so we can take a screenshot. And in this case, nothing's going on this site. See the network, nothing, system info, not much going on. I can remove this, move it to the side. And on screenshots, we have annotations. So pretty simple ones, nothing really fancy. So we got the arrow, we got square, we got the pencil, so we can say right there, and we have the text, so we can type with it. And what I would like to see here is something that'll mask a password, a phrase, or something that we don't want them to view. So for example, this square, I wish would be able to remove it, blur around or pixelate that area. I think if they add that feature, that would be really nice, okay? So I have that screenshot. I can go ahead and upload again. By default, I have it set as public, so I can go ahead and copy the link, go into incognito mode, share it, and developer's going to view this. So there we go. We have the screenshot, and there's no log on this. No, no log on the screenshot because nothing is going on, all right? And if we had members, we can invite them, we can delete it, we can add an integration to this. So there's several integrations to it, and we can add a label to this to say to do, in progress, done, or I can create my own labels to it. So actually it could be a flow where I mark them as I want. For example, if this bug's already done, well, we can tag it. We can select it if we like, we can delete it, create it. Let's go view the integrations. So these are the integrations that are available as of now. I wish they added webhooks so we can use our automations for anything like that we want to use. But for now, they have Slack, GitHub, Jira, Linear, Trello, and email notifications, okay? And there's also notifications for, these are my general settings, my workspace, personal settings, receive email updates. We have the members, if we want to invite members here, depending on the plan that you're on, are the members that you have available. And we can also create workspaces for this. So for example, this is my workspace right now, and that's what I'm using, okay? Basically, that is Bird Eats Bugs. Bird Eats Bug, right? So it's a really neat way to report bugs with a visual log of what's going on behind it, so the developers can actually view it on the back end and view what's going on, okay? So instead of just sharing a screenshot, sharing a screen recording where nothing is showing, they're actually just reproducing the visual aspect, but not the backend log of what's going on. So this is why it's important to actually report what's going on with Bird Eats Bugs. Now, this is the Chrome extension that you have to install, and the deal for that one is the link that I'll be providing in the description, but they already have 6,000 plus users and 14 reviews on this. So these guys seem to be getting started, but they are in a good start, all right? So 6,000 users is a pretty good amount. Well, that is Bird Eats Bug. Let me show you. Like I mentioned before, if you guys want to grab that deal, that link will be in the description. Like I said, starts off at $49 for the lifetime deal. And if you are constantly reporting bugs, this is a huge time saver for developers or even yourself if you're developing, because if you have the bug watch enabled on a site that you're working on, this is going to save you time because then you don't have to go reproduce the bug again because you already have it logged. Well, there you go. That is Bird Eats Bug. If you guys want to grab the deal, link will be in the description. I'll see you guys later.